traditional owners, I acknowledge you and wish you very well in the future battles we have with the state and possibly with its legal system. The joy that comes to me in being invited to an event like this is pretty hard to encapsulate in words. Goolarri's such a fantastic, enthusiastic, vibrant, an exhilarating place, and that ripples through from the top management down to anyone that has anything to do with this place. And tonight to celebrate with the graduates in their fields of competence and expertise just keeps adding to this tremendous story that I think Mr. Fong has summed up in The Wings to Fly. It's not only for Goolarri as the entity and the physical location in order to provide competent courses, competent people, competent training, etc., but to enable others, young people. Some of the people here have no telephone, have very little support structures around them in their own locations, are operating without program managers who have to be terribly resourceful in maintaining a communication system for their communities and for the benefit of many others. So Goolarri is linked into that grassroots need for communication at all levels, not just at that top level of digitisation, at the latest technology, and seeking and aspiring to become more and more competent in those fields, which it should and it must. And I endorse Mr. Fong's plea to governments to seriously enhance the capacity of this organisation to extend its capacities and its abilities and its competencies so that more and more younger people have the opportunity, not simply to be a DJ, not simply for someone to play records on a radio station, but for people to actually become investigative journalists, people to become the voices of their communities, to highlight and bring to the fore matters that are of importance to their communities and to relay national matters that are significant for their futures. There are some people who clamour in this country that remote Australia, and that primarily means the Aboriginal people, should leave their communities and go and live in a city if they're going to be part of the 20th century. Well, I reject that proposition. I reject it absolutely. What they fail to see and understand is the richness of the culture and the social values that are the hallmarks of our sustainability as Indigenous peoples for thousands upon thousands of years. The use of this technology in communication is a vehicle that enables many of those insights and stories, activities, and the strength and vitality of Aboriginal life to be relayed, not only nationally, but internationally. What a depressed and poor nation we would be if we were not able to sing the songs of the country, walk the land and visit the waterholes, to celebrate in our language the country and the ancestors, to paint its landscape and to contribute that nationally and internationally. What fool would say walk to Sydney and live in Sydney because that's where Mecca is? Let us take stock of these national dynamics, and as young graduates, you need to go beyond, as I say, the record play to get a grip of the philosophical framework within which the futures of Indigenous peoples are often crafted and decided upon without our participation. And you need to comment upon that. You need to investigate those who have the authority and exercise their jurisdictions over the top of us without our participation or our inclusion. You need to be our voice. You need to be the people at the very forefront, challenging, questioning, re-questioning if necessary, not to be fobbed off by some simple, slick answer. Because it's then that the truth emerges. It's then that the fickleness of the theory of social re-engineering of Indigenous peoples becomes exposed. This country is in need of a new philosophical framework. That is, it has to rethink the foundation around which it has operated to treat Aboriginal people. It's not a new thought. The assimilationist policies have led us to where we are, and that is the depression and despair that we see so often in many of our communities, and the loss of many of our young lives through suicide and premature death. We need a new philosophical framework that can devise policies and strategies that are about giving us the wings to fly, that is about enhancing our abilities to take care of the business that we know we are capable of doing. It is about giving us the resources in order to advance and strengthen our own peoples. Goolarri is one of those organisations at the very cutting edge of how this can be achieved through the interface of the technology and the oral tradition. We should be very proud, and I know many people here tonight and those who are listening and watching are very proud of your people who've come here to study, to work, to learn, to interact with others. Never be afraid, never be ashamed. Never stand back, because you hold the future of many of our people, and it'll be you that we will rely upon to have our voices heard and our aspirations dealt with. We require you to carry that responsibility with the diligence that you've applied to your learning. So congratulations to those of you who are graduating tonight. Congratulations to your parents and those who've supported you, because I know that's not an easy thing at times. Congratulations to both the Kimberley and the Pilbara for working together in relation to this. And congratulations to Goolarri and all its staff who've worked so magnificently to make this such a wonderful occasion. Kalia.